Hey friends, you know Azure Cache for Redis. It's a fully managed hosting service for Redis, which is an open source in-memory data structure. It enables you to create applications on Azure that handle millions of requests per second with sub-millisecond latency. Yi is here to show me how it works today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday. I'm here with Yi, who's going to talk to me about Azure Cache for Redis. How are you, sir?
Good. Thank you, Scott. And thank you for inviting me to your show.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I like scaling things and I love Redis because it is just so fast. And Azure Cache for Redis really lets us have kind of Redis as a service, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. Let's talk about Redis itself for a moment before we jump into Azure Cache for Redis. Mm-hmm. Redis is an in-memory database technology. It's been popularized, you know, because it started as an open source project. And over the years, you know, it has received a lot of community adoptions. Mm-hmm. In fact, you know, according to the Stack Overflow annual developer survey, for the last 4 years in a row, Redis has been ranked as the number one most loved database of all database technologies.
Wow, that's great.
Yeah, it's pretty remarkable. Now, of course, database covers a very broad category of technologies. Redis really is a key value pair system. So in that sense, it does not support the rich query that you typically expect from products such as SQL Server or Cosmos DB. Mm-hmm. On the other hand, you can either scale that on the SQL tier. Mm-hmm. Which means typically that you have to add more cores so that it can handle more transactions. Mm-hmm. And that comes at a cost. Putting a cache in front of that SQL server and put your common query results into that cache allows you to offload all those transaction processing from the SQL server itself. Mm-hmm. And in this particular setup, you'll be leveraging the Redis performance so that you can get to the data that you need for your application very, very quickly.
Yeah, yeah. I always encourage people to ask themselves when they say we need real-time access to this data, what does that really mean? Because it's never really real-time, right? Even caching for 5 or 10 minutes can make all the difference. And if you're talking about a product catalog or inventory or something like that, where a call to a database might be very expensive, even a short-lived cache can make all the difference in scaling. It's massive.
Absolutely. In fact, recently, we just sponsored a study through GigaOm where they took a typical web application setup and compared the performance, when you're only using a database and scale that database versus using a Redis cache in a look-aside pattern. Mm-hmm. And what they find is that, interestingly enough, in terms of both throughput and latency, you see an order of magnitude performance improvement just by having a cache next to your database.
Yeah.
In fact, you can actually use less cores in your database and still achieve those results.
Yep, absolutely. Now, do you have a demo for me?
Actually, before we get to the demo, there are a couple of things that I'd like to point out. Redis is, as I said, it is an open source. That means that you can self-Redis if you choose to. Azure Cache for Redis is a fully managed service that Microsoft provides that really takes care of all the complexity around managing and scaling Redis for you. It's turnkey. It's a service that you can set up and bring into your application literally within a few minutes. So it's super quick and it's very easy to get started with. And also it grows with you along the way. One of the really neat feature that it gives you is the ability to actually scale out your cache size on the fly so that when you need a bigger cache, you can simply do that within our service without suffering any kind of downtime. Historically, we have been hosting the open source version of the Redis. Most recently, however, we have struck a partnership with Redis Labs. Redis Labs is a third-party company. They are also the corporate custodian for the open source and the main contributor to that project. Now, of course, you know, being a commercial company, they also need a way to make money. For that, you know, they have a special version of Redis, which they have built on top of open source, but it offers a number of differentiating features. One of them is to support Redis modules. Redis modules is a technology that Redis Lab built a couple years ago that actually allows users to be able to extend the type of data structures that Redis can support. So it's a way to actually customize the Redis capabilities. With Redis Enterprise, you have a way to actually add modules as plugins. And now, as part of our hosted service, you can also use module with Azure Cache for Redis.
Interesting.
And, you know, we believe that, you know, this opens up a number of new possibilities for our customers.
Well, yeah, like I had asked the naive question about serializing JSON objects, but now by opening it up to new data types and more sophisticated data types, that's going to be a lot more powerful for enterprises, and it'll turn it into much more than a distributed hash table.
Absolutely. That way, you know, as you said, customers can choose what additional data types that they want to be able to store in Redis. So I have a quick demo here to show you.
Cool.
This demo illustrates Redis Enterprise running as part of our offerings. Here, what you're gonna see is the familiar Azure portal. And what I have here is a view that filters to the caches that I have. So to provision a Redis Enterprise cache, you use the same UI that you would otherwise for the open source version. So here I simply come to add a cache, and of course I have to pick a resource group and give this a name. And I need to choose the Azure region that I want to create the cache in. And now when I come to this dropdown, what you see are all the available options that you can have within our service. Now, there are actually two tiers that are built on top of the Redis Enterprise software. The first one is called the Enterprise Flash. Enterprise Flash is interesting in the sense that it not only uses the DRAM that's available on a VM, but it also memory extends that into any SSD or other type of non-volatile memory that you may have on a VM. So that way, you can actually, you know, create a much larger cache at a much lower cost. And again, you know, this is leveraging a proprietary technology that the Redis Lab has implemented within their software. The second set are called Enterprise. So Enterprise are also built on the software from Redis Labs. So Enterprise gives you the ability, you know, to have a module support that we talked about earlier, along with other benefits. And of course, you'll also see our current tiers that are built on top of open source. So for this demo, I'm going to pick one of the newer tiers. I'm going to choose the Enterprise E10 SKU. So this is a 12 gigabyte cache in a replicated configuration. It actually spans across multiple availability zones so that you can get 4.9 SLA, you know, with this particular setup. And all that configuration is done for you automatically. The other thing I want to point out quickly is that in a very first, we have actually integrated with the Azure Marketplace as a way for customers to acquire and purchase the Redis Lab software. This way, we have a way to integrate the billing directly into these new offerings. So the terms that you see down here, this actually comes from the marketplace. Because again, you know, this is third-party software, we want to make sure that the customers are consenting to use this software. So I'm gonna say yes. Next, you have a couple of options for connecting to this cache. You can use a public endpoint, which means that you'll be routing traffic through the internet. Now, in that case, by default, we secure the traffic using TLS. You also have the option to create a private endpoint. This is using the Azure Private Link technology, which allows you to securely connect your custom virtual network to a VNet on our side using a secure tunnel. Now, for the purpose of this demo, I'm going to stay with the public endpoint. And next, on the advanced tab, this is actually where you can select which of the custom module that you want to install with this particular cache. So for the purpose of this demo, because I'm actually going to use Redis as a search engine, I'm going to choose the Redis search option. Also, just to speed up the demo setup, I'm going to also allow non-TLS traffic to this. Again, in this case, both TLS and non-TLS options are available on the cache. From the application side, you can decide how you want to connect to it. I'm going to skip tags. And then finally, I come to the review and create. So here you can look at everything that has been configured for this particular cache. If you're happy with this configuration, then you simply hit create and off we go. So one of the first thing it's going to do is it's going to actually reach out to the marketplace and acquire the proper license to use the Redis Lab software. So when you get to this screen, that step has already succeeded. Now it is in the process of actually provisioning a cache. Now, creating a cache does take a few minutes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually switch to a cache that we have already set up for this demo. So here I have another instance of the Redis Enterprise cache, same size, same setup. For the demo, what I'm going to show you is a web application that's built on top of the Java Spring Boot as a backend, as well as Angular as a front end. So in this case, what we're using is the web application connecting to the Redis server as a data store. So for the Spring Boot application, what we are doing is that we're actually hosting that on a brand new service from Azure. This is the Azure Spring Cloud, which is another managed service for running Spring applications. So I'm going to show you what that looks like very, very quickly. So here, what I have are all the different resources that I have created for the purpose of this application. And what you see here is the Spring Cloud service. I have an application that has already been deployed for this demo. And here, what I want to show you very quickly is that this is actually a demo application that we have published on GitHub as an open source. And you can run this application in any Spring environment connecting to a Redis. And what's really neat about this entire setup is that to make this same application work with our managed service, all you have to do is to provide the special endpoint to our service. And you can do that, in fact, through the standard environments that's recommended for running these applications. So what I have here are configuration settings for the Redis host, as well as secrets that's needed to access that host. And again, all these are configured and passed in through the environment variables. And of course, with Sprint, you can also set up your own configuration server to achieve the same thing.
And if I may, it's worth pointing out, of course, that Redis supports any language. There's libraries for everything. You're doing a demo in Java and Spring, but certainly C# or Python or PHP, whatever. Redis is non-denominational in its support for languages.
Absolutely. There's actually a rich community around Redis clients. And at this point, there are some 36 different clients for different languages.
Okay.
So even within each language, you have your choice of a client library to use. So I'm going to just switch back to the demo. So this is the demo application running, again, out of the Spring Cloud connecting to Redis. And what you see here is a simple page where, in this case, this is a beer application. We have collected a large catalog of the different beer producers. So to look up a beer producer near me, all I have to do is simply type in a search query. And what this is going to do is that it's actually issuing a search command to the Redis server. And the Redis server, in this case, will look up the search keyword and return all the results to the web application. So here I have just typed in logger. And as you can see, it has found, you know, many, many choices. And one of the things that you probably notice is, you know, how quickly it is able to bring up this page. So as you can see, you know, this comes up in less than 100 milliseconds, which is really, really fast for this many results.
Yeah, it's basically just right there. The data is actually closer to the user, which is another great thing. If you've got a slower database, if you've got a high latency database, Redis can turn that into sub-millisecond results.
Absolutely.
So Redis the Redis Labs partnership is all available to us now in preview, is that correct?
That's right. So this is available to anybody with an Azure subscription to try out.
Very cool. And as a fan of the feature myself, I also want to point out to folks that there's the enterprise SKU, and you saw, you know, many, many, many gigabyte sized Redis caches available. But for regular folks or small businesses like myself, there are also smaller ones. So it is for everyone. There's a slider ball that goes all the way up to cache everything or even cache small amounts. So Redis and Redis Cache for Azure is for everyone.
Absolutely.
Fantastic. I am learning all about how to scale my cloud app with Azure Cache for Redis today on Azure Friday.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it. Watch more Azure Friday.